Immortal Mentor, written by Kirk Anthony Ford. Introduction. In the shadowed corners of human understanding, a question lingers, heavy with the breath of millennia. Can the essence of life itself be not just extended, but rendered unending? Herein lies our conundrum, a puzzle that has ensnared philosophers and prophets alike. Why has the promise of immortality, so clearly inscribed in ancient texts, been left to gather dust in the recesses of our collective consciousness? Picture a world where the finality of death is but a faint whisper, overrun by the resounding echo of eternal life. Have we, as seekers of truth and wisdom, fallen prey to our own limitations, our vision clouded by a lack of revelation? Why do we falter at the threshold of immortality, our steps unsure? Could it be that the key has always been within our grasp, hidden in plain sight, waiting for the illumination of genuine wisdom to reveal its potency? It is a baptism of fire, a mantle of sonship bestowed upon us, yet scarcely claimed. What if I told you that immortality is not a distant dream, but a present reality, an unfolding revelation through the gospel? As the pages turn, a narrative unfolds, one that beckons you to step beyond the veil of the temporal, to embrace a truth so profound that it has the power to reshape the very fabric of existence. But dare we wield such knowledge to become the heirs of an immortal legacy? The path lies before us, fraught with the unknown, and it is here, at the precipice of discovery, that I must leave you on the cusp of eternity. In a world teeming with fleeting pleasures and ephemeral joys, the human heart yearns for something more enduring, a promise of permanence amidst the relentless tide of time. This yearning is as old as humanity itself, a deep-seated desire that has driven the greatest quests and defined the noblest pursuits. Yet despite our advancements, the riddle of eternal life remains unsolved, an enigma wrapped in the shrouds of our finite understanding. It is this very riddle that I, Kirk Anthony, aim to unravel through the pages of Immortal Mentor. Our society, rich in knowledge and technological prowess, stands at a crossroads where the ancient paths of wisdom seem overgrown by the weeds of modern skepticism. We pride ourselves on our intellectual achievements, yet we have failed to grasp the full magnitude of the life-giving truths that have been gifted to us. There is a mantle of sonship, a divine legacy that has been offered to all of humanity, yet it lies unclaimed, like a treasure locked away in a chest for which we have misplaced the key. The impact of our collective oversight is profound. We live in the shadows of mortality, our days numbered, our aspirations shackled by the looming specter of death. The vibrant colors of life are dulled by the inevitability of decay, and the beauty of our experiences is tainted by the certainty of their end. We are, in essence, a race, running a race against time, never quite able to savor the fullness of our existence, for the dread of its conclusion haunts our every step. And yet, within this bleak landscape, there are those who have glimpsed a different reality, a hint of the immortal. I recall a story that stirred my soul to its very core, a tale of a man who had been touched by the divine, who had seen beyond the veil of this temporal realm. At the tender age of 9, while wandering the icy expanses of Alaska, he was visited by a figure of radiant light, a being who spoke of life beyond the bounds of death. This man, whom I have the privilege of knowing intimately, was none other than myself, and the encounters that followed at 23, 25, and 27 only served to cement the truth that had been revealed to me. The stakes could not be higher. The very essence of our existence hangs in the balance, the possibility of a life unencumbered by the fear of death. To ignore the call to immortality is to resign ourselves to a cycle of birth and decay, to forsake the gift that has been so lavishly offered to us. But to heed the call, is to step into a realm of boundless potential, to live fully and without regret, with the knowledge that our story does not end with the final breath. As we embark on this journey together, let me offer you a glimpse of the path that lies ahead. Through the wisdom of the gospel, as revealed in the writings of apostles and prophets, and illuminated by the light of 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 9 and 10, we will explore the contours of this mantle of sonship. This baptism of fire, once witnessed in the Son of God within the fiery furnace, is not a mere metaphor but a tangible reality that can be experienced in the here and now. Immortal Mentor is not just another book, it is a call to awaken, rise from the ashes of our limited understanding, and embrace the fullness of life promised to us. It is a guide, a map to the buried treasure of immortality that awaits those brave enough to seek it. With each chapter, we will peel back the layers of mystery that have shrouded this truth, bringing to light the revelations that have the power to transform the very essence of what it means to be human. So, I invite you, dear reader, to join me on this quest for the immortal, to dare to believe in the incredible, and to open your heart to the profound possibilities that await. Together, we will uncover the secrets long forgotten and step boldly into the promise of an unending tomorrow. Are you ready to take the first step? Can you feel the stirrings of eternity within your soul? The journey of a thousand lifetimes begins with the turn of a page. Welcome to Immortal Mentor. Chapter 1. The Genesis of Immortality. The Immortal Blueprint. The book of the generation of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Matthew chapter 1, verse 1, KJV. Generation in Greek is the word Genesis. Jesus is the regeneration or the genesis of life and immortality. At the heart of every human endeavor lies the search for meaning, for a purpose that transcends the ordinary, grounding our fleeting existence in something eternal. It is this quest that has led us to the doorsteps of history's greatest teacher, whose words echo through time with the promise of life unending. The teachings of Jesus of Nazareth, illuminated in the sacred scriptures, offer not just solace, but a blueprint for immortality, a path laid out with the precision of a master craftsman. The central theme of this journey is no less than the secret to eternal life, a blueprint sketched in the dust of ancient roads and inscribed upon the hearts of those who would follow. To understand this mystery, we delve into the core teachings of Jesus, teachings that are both a promise and a meticulous process. The main assertion of our exploration is bold, yet it stands firmly upon the foundation of historical and theological scrutiny. Jesus proffered a blueprint for immortality, a series of steps and principles that, if embraced and enacted, could lead to life everlasting. Our primary evidence for such a claim can be found within the Beatitudes, the poetic and profound statements Jesus shared during the Sermon on the Mount. Here, he outlined the attitudes and behaviors that align with the kingdom of heaven, a kingdom not limited by the constraints of temporal existence. "Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God," he proclaimed, linking the purification of one's inner life with the vision of the eternal. We must delve deeper into the evidence, examining each beatitude as a component of this blueprint. The call to humility, to hunger and thirst for righteousness, to be merciful, to be peacemakers, each of these pronouncements carries with it the weight of eternal implications. To embody these virtues is to align oneself with the divine nature, a nature that knows no end. Yet there are counter-evidence and counter-arguments aplenty. Critics argue that the Beatitudes are idealistic at best, impossible standards that serve only to highlight human frailty. They contend that immortality as a concept is a myth, a comforting narrative crafted to ease the sting of our inevitable demise. In rebuttal, we return to the very source of our claim, the scriptures themselves, which offer numerous accounts of individuals who encountered the divine and were transformed. Consider the tale of Lazarus brought back from the dead, a story that illustrates the power over mortality Jesus claimed to possess and impart to others. Additional supporting evidence lies in the practices of the early Christian community. Their radical commitment to the teachings of Jesus, even in the face of death, suggests they had tapped into a source of life that transcended their earthly trials. Their unwavering faith serves as a testament to the transformative power of the blueprint before us. As we reach the conclusion of this chapter, we reinforce the assertion that Jesus laid out a blueprint for immortality. The evidence is manifold, found in the Beatitudes, the miracles, and the lives of the early disciples. Each element points to a process that is as practical as it is profound, promising a life that stretches beyond the horizon of death. So we stand at the threshold of understanding, gazing into the depths of a promise that has captivated the hearts of generations. The blueprint is before us, intricate and inviting. Dare we take up the tools provided and build upon the foundation laid by the Immortal Mentor? Can we embody the principles that promise not just life, but life everlasting? The journey is arduous, the path steeped in mystery. Yet with each step forward, we move closer to the realization of a dream as old as time itself. The Immortal Blueprint is not just a set of teachings. It is an invitation to step into a reality where death has lost its sting, and life in all its fullness beckons us onward. Are you prepared to embrace this journey? Will you let the ancient words take root in your heart and guide you to a destiny that defies the grave? The choice lies before you, an open door to a realm where the immortal heart beats strong, undimmed by the shadows of mortality. Welcome to the next chapter of Immortal Mentor. The blueprint awaits. Sonship defined. Understanding sonship, particularly in the realm of immortality, requires a foray into a lexicon rich with meaning and history. These terms are not mere words. They are the lifeblood of a profound concept that has traversed time, shaping legacies and destinies. Embarking on this exploration, it becomes evident why the unveiling of these terms is not just beneficial, but essential. For without a firm grasp on the language of sonship, one might as well be adrift in an ocean of wisdom without a compass. It is with this understanding that we begin to pass the sacred vocabulary of eternal lineage. To navigate these waters, we introduce a lexicon of the most pivotal terms: sonship, immortality, mentorship, legacy, and transfiguration. Each word is a pillar supporting the grand edifice of our discussion. Sonship, the cornerstone of our exploration, is more than biological lineage. It is the conscious adoption of a mentor's values, virtues, and vision. When we speak of the sonship of the immortal, we refer not to the perpetuation of genetic material, but to the continuation of ideals and wisdom that surpass the boundaries of mortality. Immortality, often misconstrued as mere unending existence, in truth, embodies the essence of a life that is imperishable in value, influence, and manifestation. It is the enduring impact of a life well lived, one that resonates through the ages and inspires the living while entering within the veil. Mentorship in this sacred context is not a simple transfer of knowledge. It is the careful cultivation of another's potential, guiding them toward their own path of enlightenment and immortality. Legacy is the imprint left upon the sands of time, a tapestry woven from one's actions, teachings, and the lives touched. It is what survives us, the story told in our stead, and the light we kindle in others that burns beyond our final breath. Lastly, transfiguration is the journey beyond the ordinary, the ascent to a higher state of being and understanding. It is the ultimate goal of sonship and the heart of immortality. Mentorship, too, finds its reflection in the world around us. The relationship between Elijah and Elisha, Jesus and the apostles, Andrew Carnegie and Dr. Napoleon Hill, President Barack Obama and President Joe Biden exemplifies a mentorship that shaped culture itself. Jesus's works carry the voice of his immortal mentorship into our present, a testament to the power of shared wisdom. Legacy is evident in the foundations laid by pioneers and visionaries. Martin Luther King Jr. S. dream of equality and justice did not perish with him. It continues to inspire action and change, a legacy that transcends his temporal life. Transfiguration is the pursuit that drives individuals to scale the peaks of human limitations. It is the spirit that propelled humankind to the moon, not merely as a physical feat, but as a leap into a broader understanding of our place in the cosmos. If we can get to the moon, what about mentorship from the sun? Matthew chapter 17, verse 2. As we draw this exploration to a close, let us reflect on the profound weight each term carries. These are not just definitions, they are the threads that weave the fabric of a concept that has, does, and will continue to shape the human narrative. Sonship, in the context of immortality, is an ever-unfolding story, a mantle passed down through the ages, inviting each of us to take up the charge and extend the lineage of wisdom and virtue into an eternal future. The discourse on sonship does not end here. It is merely a pause, a moment to gather the threads before weaving them into the larger tapestry of immortal mentorship. The journey continues, and with each step, the definitions provided here will illuminate the path, guiding us deeper into the mysteries of eternal life and legacy. Are these concepts merely philosophical constructs, or do they hold tangible significance in your life? As you ponder this, consider the immortality of your actions, the mentorship you might provide, and the legacy you are crafting at this very moment. The mantle in action. In the hush of twilight, a gentle breeze whispered through the olive trees of ancient Jerusalem, carrying with it the soft, earnest voices of two men deep in conversation. The younger man, a devoted student, hung on every word of his teacher, a prophet whose wisdom seemed as boundless as the stars beginning to pierce the dusky sky. This was no ordinary exchange. It was the passing of a mantle, the sacred sonship of spiritual lineage being lovingly draped over eager, waiting shoulders. The teacher, known to us through the annals of history as the prophet Elijah, was a figure of such fiery faith and miraculous power that his very presence seemed to alter the atmosphere. By his side was Elisha, a young man whose resolute gaze betrayed his determination to inherit not just the cloak that would soon fall from Elijah's ascension, but also the depth of character and divine purpose that his mentor embodied. As they walked and talked, Elisha's heart raced with an anticipation that eclipsed fear. He knew this night would change everything. Elijah's narrative had been punctuated by the spectacular, raising the dead, calling down fire from heaven, outrunning chariots. And now, Elisha stood on the cusp of stepping into a story that would intertwine with his own, a narrative of divine mentorship, culminating in a chariot of fire and horses of flame. Can you imagine the surge of emotion in that sacred moment? The longing for a double portion of Elijah's spirit? The raw yearning for a legacy that would outlive the mortal coil? Elisha's journey was laden with the unexpected, a testament to the unpredictable nature of carrying the mantle. Yet, it was a journey that would cement his place in the continuum of divine sonship. Fast forward several millennia, and the mantle of mentorship continues to cascade through time, reaching modern shores with undiminished power. In the heart of Honolulu, a young man named Kirk finds himself grappling with the weight of his own inheritance. An Air Force veteran, highly decorated, and a summa cum laude graduate, he was no stranger to discipline and excellence. Yet, his encounter with the divine at the tender age of 9 had set him on a path that no military precision or academic accolade could have prepared him for. Kirk's story, much like a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.